Hello everyone and welcome in today's webinar. Thank you for joining us in the topic Customer Claims Management, a new paradigm. My name is Tim Rama, the marketing supervisor at PCB, and it is my pleasure to introduce to you Cyrus Karanja, systems coordinator at Tetra Pak and a well-practiced professional with over 9 years of experience in areas of quality, health, safety and environmental management, especially dealing with ISO standards. Today, for 30 minutes, you will be able to learn something new, the customer claims management, what is this new paradigm, and have the chance to ask your questions related to this topic directly to Cyrus, either by writing the comment box in the right-hand control panel or by raising your hand and we will enable you to speak. I hope you enjoy this, and without further ado, Cyrus, you may continue. Thank you.
Okay, hello everyone. Thank you so much for joining me in this webinar, and I'm hoping that we'll all learn something new. My presentation today is on customer claims management, and specifically a new way of looking at it, not really new, but a different way of looking at customer claims. I'm hoping that in the next 30 minutes we'll all be able to learn. Welcome on board. Well, so the webinar is only for 30 minutes. I'll start with an introduction and a few teasers, questions to just jog our minds. And then we'll look at why customers make claims or complaints and how we as organizations react to these complaints or claims. And then we'll look at this new way of looking at claims or complaints, and then we'll have a session at the end for questions and answers. Okay, so a customer claim or complaint is an expression of dissatisfaction or discontentment with a good or service by a customer. Business organizations are in the business of offering either goods or services to clients out there. And periodically, once in a while, you'll get a customer who's not satisfied with either product features or aspects of services offered. And they will then lodge a claim or a complaint. And as we proceed, I'd like us to just look at a few things. And I got this data from several sources. And the first one is that if you pick any typical business, only 4% of its dissatisfied customers will actually get back to the organization to inform it that they're not satisfied with either the goods or services provided. Ideally, if you were to take 26 customers, only one out of them would actually bother to complain. These are really bad indictment on organizations, because it would point to the fact that customers feel like there's no point complaining because they'll not get listened to. So that's something to think about even as we proceed. Then consider this, that news of poor customer service will reach twice as many ears as praise for good service. So a bad customer experience will be heard by twice as many people as a good experience. And then it's 6 to 7 times more expensive to acquire a new customer than to retain an existing one. We are better off retaining the customers that we have than trying to recruit new ones out there. It's really, really hard. It takes a lot of time and effort. We already have a pool of customers. If treated well, we will be able to retain and get more business from them. We need to be able to address customer issues. I have proposed here, it's not really a new way, there are organizations out there which are practicing this, but for common knowledge, I think it's important for us to look at all this. It's a generic kind of way of handling customers, and it's about how we need it with customers. And you'll find that most organizations will look at customer claims management is a cost. A customer places a claim and you start thinking of, oh, how much will it cost? How much will the activities that go into all resetting the trauma, handling communications and all that, how much will it cost? You look at it as a cost. Forgetting that actually proper claims handling and management is an investment for the long term. A satisfied customer will give you more business. And more so a customer whose issues you've handled properly. So we need to change our thinking from looking at customer claims management as a cost to looking at it actually as an investment. But we'll even give you business on our partner as well. So ultimately you gain more than you actually lose. So the winning way now is actually treating that is only actually bother to send feedback to the organization. So important for you view or look at our products or services that we offer. And if we had we have a bad customers, they talk to us if they have any feedback. And not just feedback, as in the customer is things or service, we find what we should do or that actually suits customer needs. The only way of doing this is getting feedback from the customer. Acknowledge that immediately. Do not give an impression that you are a team. It's important for you to raise here that the team may need to be multidisciplinary. Take the example of a manufacturing kind of setup, where you have a plant that manufactures products, consumer products, for instance, and they send them out to the market, and then you get a claim or a complaint from customers. You may think that all you need is maybe your QAT assurance to look at it. Manufacturing, a defect in the manufacturing, there could be an issue with to my team, doesn't need to be static. It varies or complaint that comes from a customer. And then from the outset, let's open communications with the customer. We'll get pissed off, not because organizations, but because there are a lot of issues with them at each point of our process. When you receive the claim, acknowledge it and let them know that you received it and you're investigating, you've considered a team. And then let them know at every point of the way what it is that you're doing. And that way they actually become involved. They become part of the solution rather than being, rather than us looking at them as a problem. And then it's important for some claims to actually give an intermediate solution as you seek a permanent solution. Take the example of an industrial goods manufacturer. And by this I mean a manufacturer who manufactures stuff that doesn't go out to market immediately, but rather goes to another firm or business organization that now uses it to actually now produce a product for the final customer. And in this case, I'll take an example of a company that manufactures packaging material. It doesn't sell this packaging material to the final consumer directly, but it sells to another organization. And if you had a claim from this other organization on the packaging material, then even as you seek to sort out the issue, it's important to actually give an intermediate solution. And this intermediate solution could be recalling the bad product or the defective product and giving them an substitute, replacing what it is that was bad so that they can continue running even as you dig deeper and try to find out the root cause of the problem. And in that way, the customer doesn't suffer any loss and he's more inclined or he'll be more inclined to actually give you an ear even as you carry on with the rest of the complaint or claim investigation. And then it's very important now after having provided the intermediate solution, it's important to carry out a root cause analysis because claims are not in themselves good for business in the sense that when something wrong happens, then you don't want to have it happen again. And the only way you can prevent this from happening or recurring again is by actually addressing it conclusively or effectively. And you do that by establishing the root cause of the defect or the problem, and then making proper or defining proper solutions to sort it out once and for all. And then again, it's important to still involve the customer, still part of communication and engagement with the customer. So it's good to involve them even in the analysis. Once you've done your root cause, then you propose corrective actions and then develop these actions and test them before you actually even implement them to sort out your issue. Once your solutions have been defined and tested, validated, then you apply them, and then you now monitor to prevent recurrence and also try to draw some value from the whole thing by actually applying the learnings from that episode to other areas of the business. It's important to build on the learnings, because ideally all that which you gain during this customer claims management process can actually be built into a body of knowledge that actually gives you a competitive advantage. Take, for instance, a company which has collected data on claims that it has received for the last 10 years, and not just data on the claims themselves, but even the root causes and what solutions were offered. You agree with me that such a company is actually better placed than a competitor who has a disjointed way of looking at customer claims, who handles them as they come and doesn't keep any data or information. This first organization actually has over time built its capability and capacity to address issues by leveraging on previous claims handling episodes. So it's important to actually draw learnings from the experience. So as we conclude, it's good to remember that happy customers will always often return and also inform others, basically bring you even more business. And unhappy customers may not only not return, but they will tell many others of their bad experience, and in that way even make you lose more business. And lastly, it's important for us to realize that claims and complaints are a factor of business. As long as we're in business, we'll get claims. We'll get complaints from customers. So let's accept it as a factor of business, and let's now work towards turning these claims and complaints to our advantage, actually, by ensuring that we deal with them properly, and in that way, make our customers happy and possibly even get more business from them. And beyond that, we'll also draw learnings. We'll get to know what it is in our processes and systems that are not working, and we improve on that, prevent recurrence. And a consistent approach of this systematic way of sorting customer issues actually makes businesses better over the long term. So that was it. It was a short presentation, and I'll invite questions at this time. So the floor is open. You may ask a question either directly or via chat.
Thank you, Cyrus. Thank you for this great presentation. I believe attendees joined as well. And once again, I would like to apologize to all of the attendees for having to postpone the webinar session. And maybe this is the reason they couldn't attend, some of them. However, you have always the chance to write us an email about any questions that you may have about this topic. And we, together with Cyrus, will be happy to answer for any questions that you may have related to this topic. Once again, thank you, Cyrus, for this presentation and for finding time out of your busy schedule to joining us. I would like to also thank the attendees for joining us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, where we will be publishing the recorded session of this webinar. And also, you may have the chance to watch all other videos that we publish there. Also, you can check our schedule in our website for the upcoming webinars. Many different topics, interesting and hot topics, are coming. So stay up to date and stay tuned. And see you next week. Thank you, and have a great weekend all. Bye-bye.
Okay, thank you, team. Bye.